show you how to operate the 1ELECTRICAL electrical cooker. So first I'm going to switch on power. It is plugged on a switch here. The cooker comes with this one hot plate and these three gas burners. We have the smaller one, we have the medium one, and this large one. So these three uses gas, while this one uses power from electricity. The best thing with this cooker is that even if it is not connected to electricity, you can still use a lighter or a matchbox to light the gas burners. So let me show you how to light the burners. First I'm going to light using a matchbox, and before I light, let me take you through the knobs that are used to light the burners and the hot. When the white line of the knob is facing upwards like this, that shows that all the knobs are turned off, or the cooker is turned off. So we have this first knob. You can see that we have a square, and this square has a dot on the right side here, bottom at the corner. So that shows it is for lighting this smaller gas burner. We have the second knob. It has a square and it has a dot on top at the right here, and that shows that it is for lighting this burner here. Then we have this knob. It has a dot on the left high at the corner here, up here. So that shows it is for lighting the hot plate. And then we have this knob. It has this square and it has a dot at the corner here on the bottom part. And that shows that it is for lighting this larger gas burner. So we have this button here. It produces spark and it is an igniter. So if you don't have a lighter or a matchbox, it uses electricity power, so you can just light using this spark. So let's first light using a matchbox and see how it lights. So for you to light, I'm going to light my matchbox like that and then press in the button, and then you turn it to the left like that, and then you light. Have the second one, you press in, turn it to the left, and then you light. You have the third one, you press in, turn to the left, and then you light. So these are all gas burners. Let me switch off one. For you to switch off, you just turn this knob to the right like that, and you turn off the flame. So with this electrical cooker, you can control your flame from high flame. You can control it to medium by turning the knob slowly towards the right, slowly to medium or low, according to the flame that you want to switch off. You just turn it to the right like that. To turn on the hot plate, we have this knob, so you just turn it to the right like that. You see this is facing, this white line is facing to the right, and then you see that this power indicator here is on, showing that the hot plate is switched on, is turned on. So this other power indicator here is for the oven. When you turn on the oven, it will turn red like this one. So for the hot plate, you can control it to low heat, to medium heat when it is facing downwards, and to maximum heat when it is facing to the right. When this line is facing to the right, that is maximum heat. And then you can switch off like that. You can see that this line is facing upward, and when you switch off, there is no light here, showing that it is off. This other power indicator is for the oven. If you turn on the oven, you will see that it will light. Let's see. You turn on the oven, you set the temperature, and you turn the timer. You can see that it is lighting. So this is for the oven. This one is for the hot plate. When it comes to the oven, we have these three knobs here. We have this knob, we have this knob, and we have this knob. We have said that these knobs that have these squares on top, they are for operating the upper part, the burners and the hot plate. So we are remaining with these three knobs. We start with this knob. You can see that it has two lines here. It has two lines here, and it has this one line here. So this is for controlling heat in the oven. If you want heat from the oven to come from up and down, you turn the knob like this to the left, such as this white line is facing to the left. If you want the heat to come from up, then this white line should be facing downwards. So you turn the knob again such that this line is facing downwards. So heat is coming from up. If you want heat to come from down here, then turn the knob to the right such that this line is facing to the right side. When the line is facing upwards, that means that the oven is off and there is no heat that is coming from the oven. Let's go to this other knob. You can see that it is calibrated in degrees Celsius. So it is from 0 degrees to the maximum. You have 40, 85, 130, 180 to 25 to the maximum. This knob is used to set the temperature that you want according to the recipe that you are using. So you can just adjust. It is just rotating by itself. You can turn it to high, medium, low temperature, or you can read the calibrations and set it according to the temperature that you want. Then we have this other knob here. It is the timer. You can see that it has something that looks like a clock. So it is calibrated from 0 to 60 minutes. So you just set your timer. If you want your food to cook for 30 minutes, you put it where the line should be pointing the 30 minutes mark. So when time is over, it will keep on turning until it reaches the zero mark here. And the oven has an audible signal that you will hear to indicate that the time is up for cooking your meal is ready, or whatever you're cooking or baking or roasting. So if you need to increase time, maybe now you can add your time. If you want to add for 10 minutes, for 20 minutes, you can adjust according to the time that you want. So let me show you how it works. Let's say now you are operating the oven and you are maybe baking or roasting. You want the heat to come from up and down. Set the temperature. Maybe you want to cook with a temperature of 180 degrees like that, and you want to bake for 40 minutes. So that is how you should set your oven. You can see that there is lighting in the oven. So make sure that when you are checking if your food is ready, the window of the oven is always closed and you can check through the window to prevent loss of heat. So we have this other thing here which looks like a hook on this button. We have this button In the oven we have this thing, you can see it. This is called a spit or a rotisserie. It is used to hold meat cuttings or to hold potli if you want to roast potli as it rotates in the oven. It has these skewer clamps where you attach your poultry, and then you attach it somewhere here, inside here. Do not attach it inside here, and then it will start rotating. You can see that the spit is rotating, so that is how your piece of meat rotates in the oven as it cooks. So make sure when you're rotating your meat, you remove this plastic material, this one. Make sure you remove it because it can burn, because the oven is very hot. So let me put off. The oven comes with two trays. I have two trays here. I have this tray and I have this other tray. They are big enough, so you can use the trays for baking. It also comes with two racks. You have this one and this one, where you place your spit or the rotisserie that is used to roast chicken or roast cut of meat. So when you're roasting here, it is good that you place the tray below what you are roasting, so that it can collect the drippings down there. When it comes to a rack placement, this bottom part here is normally used for roasting. So apart from the spit, you can place your rack here and you roast your meat. Especially when you're roasting large cuts of meat, you can use the bottom part here. We have the middle part that is used for baking. In most baking, positioning the food in the center of the oven is ideal. When it comes to the top part, this top part here is used for toasting and broiling. Toasting is when you are browning food by exposure to a dry heat, and broiling is exposing food to direct radiant heat. Broiling is similar to grilling, only that when grilling, the heat source is below, but in oven broiling, the heat source is above here. The bottom of the rack is also great for crusts, breads and pizzas, goods that you want to brown on the bottom. Baking and browning results may vary widely based on the rack position, where you place your rack, the type of bakeware that you use, air circulation and temperature variations. If it is important that the cake browns at the bottom, then place the rack down, and if it is important that the cake browns on top, then place the rack high. Position the racks before turning on the oven for optimal performance, and always make sure that you use oven gloves because the oven is very hot. Make sure that the racks are leveled well. When it comes to the type of bakeware that you are using, we have dark coated pans, and these absorb heat, which result to darker browning, while shiny pans reflect heat, which result to lighter browning. So use the pan type that achieve the level of browning most appropriate for what you are baking. When using shiny insulated pans, some baked goods may require some additional times because the shiny pans normally reflect heat. When it comes to air circulation, to cook food evenly in the oven, ensure that there is hot air circulating to inches around the bakeware on top. When you're using two pans in the oven, such that maybe one is here and the other one is here, do not let the pans to touch each other, because that may result to hot spots and faster cooking around the areas that they touch. So again, preheating the oven before you start baking, it is necessary for good results. Most ovens, they have audible signals to indicate when the oven is preheated. Again, always use the oven light to check whether what you're baking is cooking, because that helps to maintain the temperature of the oven. I believe that was helpful. Thank you for watching. Comment down below and don't forget to like, share and subscribe.